Champions of Deer certainly put down a marker in round one. No mean feat playing one lean in of his last year's semi-final. They really came up trumps. 5 points win in the end, but they were comfortable for long periods before one lean scored two late goals. Adair looked pretty much at full strength in that game, and that's a daunting task for the rest of the championship and for the remainder of opposition. But this weekend they face the Father Casey's team with a big win also in round one against St. Sennans. Two sides of hand got it to knockout stages last year, but Jamie Fieldman really put down a marker in that one. Big scores from Jamie O'Connor and from Adrian Wright. So they'll look to build on that. They've shown promise before, we all know of their underage talent, but putting two performances together would be a big thing for them. It's the biggest test they could have with the champions of Dare. As I said, they looked at full strength last week. When they're at full strength, they've got options all over the field. I always wonder about their strength and depth, but they really do have a really, really strong 15. And for Abbey Field to face up to them this weekend can be a big test of the progress they're making, but won't maybe define their season as long as they get a reasonable performance. After that, we've got St. Sennans and Ballylanders. Absolute opposite of the first game I spoke of. Two teams that need to find something after last weekend. Two big defeats, two double-digit defeats. Maybe defeats that you wouldn't have expected. Ballylanders, county finalists last year, but just didn't get out of the traps at all the last day out. Found it hard to get scores, and maybe that's something that will come against them. They don't have maybe proven scorers on a consistent basis. Rely a lot on frees, but nothing really worked for them the last day out. St. Sennans, you know, look reasonably strong on paper, look to have the forwards, a couple of forwards, but again, found it very hard to get going against Father Casey's. A result here is a big thing. You don't want to face in to the long summer break with two defeats. So, you know, the winner here really puts themselves into a positive frame of mind, while for the loser, you know, a long summer ahead. Final game of this group, Ballysteen and Monaleen. You know, Ballysteen, you know, big winners, beating Ballylanders in that round one game, and probably wanted to put down a marker that day, and they did it. A bit like Father Casey's, they need to back it up, and you know, they're facing a more lean side. They'll probably be hurting after losing to Adair. They battled back well in the end in that game, but just seem to find scores a bit hard. They scored 3-5, two goals from penalties. You know, for a club like Modeline to become hard by scores, they wouldn't really expect that. They've got the forwards, and they'll look to bounce back. This is probably a really intriguing game for me. Can Ballysteen continue? Will Modeline bounce back? This one could be very, very close.
Right, round two kicks off on Friday night with the meeting of Tom Bradford and Ula in Kilmallock. It's the meeting of two clubs that had contrasting fortunes in the first round. Ula had a big win over newly promoted Galway, and in the process scored five goals. And it certainly is the start that they would have dreamt of, because they had a pretty difficult season last year, Ula, in that they just, I think they just won one game towards the end, which against St. Pat's, which prevented them from being involved in the relegation playoff. So they would be pleased to have got a win under their belt. And Ula will see Friday night's game as an opportunity, perhaps, to get a second win and to go into the summer on full points, because they face a Drum Bradford side that suffered a very, very heavy defeat in the opening round of the championship last weekend when they went down to Newcastle West. And last year was the first year in almost two decades that Drum Bradford did not qualify for the knockout stages of the competition. They just won one game in the group stage, and that was against the Pearson. It will be a tight game on Friday evening. I cannot see the Drum Bradford defence being as benevolent in conceding goals as Galway were last weekend. But I think that Ula will take a certain confidence from it and they'll take it into the game. And I think that Ula might just about share this one. Then on Saturday night, and I suppose no disrespect to the other four teams, but we have the big one out. We have the big one of the round in Group 2. It's the meeting of St. Kieran's and Newcastle West. And in terms of the group stage, for these two clubs, very, very little has changed. Last year, they met in the final round of the group stage and went into the final round, both on the back of four wins. And it was just both qualified, of course, for the knockout stages, and it was just a battle for first and second place, for semi-final and quarter-final places. Newcastle West won it on that occasion, 15 points to 110, and so qualified for the semi-final, where they were surprisingly beaten by Ballylanders. And of course, St. Kieran's went on and lost, having missed out on the knockout stages narrowly and heartbreakingly, I suppose, for 2 or 3 years before last year, went on to the quarterfinal and suffered a bit of a surprise defeat to Mona Lane. Now, Knockaderry on Saturday night will not certainly be a place for the faint-hearted, because this will be a full-blooded championship game. I have seen them here in St. Kieran's in their win over the Pearshick. Obviously, Newcastle West were quite impressive against Drum Bradford when they scored. Racked up 120, it's a big score in a football match. Newcastle West, at the outset of every year, are the perennial favourites for the championship. They won it in 2015, they haven't won it since. Mike Quilligan is back on board for the third time. I'm leaning towards Newcastle West, but it comes with a health warning in that it's a local rivalry, it's local derby, very often form goes out the window. I'm going cautiously for Newcastle West. The group will be completed on Sunday night when Galway and the Pearshick meet in Brough. And in many ways, I suppose, these two sides after the first round could be best described as companions in distress. They have both suffered heavy defeats. Galway, as I already said, to Ula and the Pearshick to St. Kieran's. It's a game that neither side can afford to lose. I think Galway will be very, very disappointed. Because everything seemed to be going so well for them for the last couple of years. They reached the intermediate final in 2017, lost to St. Simons, and it doesn't always happen, and rarely enough does it happen. They came back the following year and won better, and really came up with high hopes after a four-year absence. From senior ranks, but they will be hugely disappointed with the performance against Ula. So they will really have to put that behind them. The Pearshick are carrying on in the same vein as they were last year. The Pearshick haven't won a game in the group stages since 2017. They will see this as an opportunity. I think. Galway were without a few players for the game against Ula. If they're back on board, I feel that they just might share it.